Before I start this video off, I'm gonna credit Mike Fox because I don't want to get dislikes or hate because he's the original owner of making this whole prank text call thingy. Alright, yo guys, what is up? Solo in here. I'm back with a new video and I'm gonna be doing a lyric text prank video. I know this idea is extremely cringe, but so many people have been doing it lately on YouTube. I saw this one chick, she did it on her like ex-boyfriend in quote. She ended up getting like 900,000 views on it and her channel just fucking blew up. With YouTube nowadays, you have to be at the right place at the right time and the right date, right everything, and then you just blow up. It's fucking crazy. Yeah, just to sum it up, so many people have just been doing it lately and I just decided to hop on the bandwagon with this since everybody was doing it, and I was just like, all right, if that dude blew up, maybe I might blow up by doing it. Hashtag solo is a sellout, hashtag solo is roasted, hashtag solo only wants views, hashtag. I put like no effort into this video at all. Like when I mean no effort, I'm talking about like a 30 minute edit. Like this shit took no time to edit. So if this video somehow blows up, I'm low-key gonna be pissed as fuck. Like, I don't know. One half of me is just gonna be happy as fuck that a video that I made actually ended up bringing up some traction. And then the other half of me is just gonna be like, okay, well, I put this much work into this video and that video didn't blow up. But I mean, it's YouTube, shit happens and you just have to be at the right place at the right time. Also, I want to really apologize if I sound kind of stupid right now. I went to a concert yesterday. Lil Uzi, Kid Cudi, Ray Stremmerd, so many fucking artists were there. Dude, we were screaming the fuck our asses up. Wait, that makes no sense. Screaming the fuck our asses up. Okay, I'm gonna be making a full vlog on it tomorrow, so stay tuned. I'm telling you, you have to watch it. It was so lit. Yeah, getting that out of the way, because my voice is like really sore, so whatever what you're hearing right now is just me forcing myself to actually talk, because I wanted to be as consistent as I can on YouTube. Okay, long story short, I used to like this one chick in middle school, and I had like a huge crush on her, okay? One day, I tried asking her out, and the way I asked her out, I know you guys are just gonna call me fucking retarded for this. So basically, I wrote a note asking, hey, so-and-so, would you like to go out with me? I like you. It was just so cringe, man. Like, I don't even feel like talking about it. It was just people that knew me from middle school would know, but it was just extremely cringe. I slipped it into her locker. The next day, she told one of my friends I was friends with her. I know it's kind of weird. I have a friend that's friends with the crush that I like that, okay. So he was basically like my wingman. He was my friend that was friends with my crush, basically. So he was like my hookup. He was my plug. You know what I'm saying? He was the plug, cuz. He basically kind of transmitted messages because I was too scared to talk to her. I don't know why I was scared to talk to her, to be honest. So she told him to tell me that she rejected my asking of outs. She said that I was weird and just all this other shit, and I can completely agree with her. Looking back to all this shit I've said in middle school and all the things I've recorded in middle school and all the tweets and Instagram posts, I was just a really cringe kid. If anybody that's watching this video that knew me in middle school and wasn't really friends with me, I understand why you weren't friends with me. I was just completely weird. I was just ugly as fuck. And I was just sad. Speaking about being ugly, I was ugly. I was ugly as fuck. And I'm still ugly now. I mean, I can't admit, I'm not a fucking Justin Bieber or some shit, but in middle school, I was ugly as fuck, okay? I mean, ugly. Like, I'm talking about dirt on the floor ugly. I tried comparing it to something that was relevant towards ugly, but I didn't end up thinking about dirt. So, yeah. It's been about, like, 4 years since I asked her out in quote. And basically, the other day, I asked my friend if he could give me her number just so I could do this for this YouTube video. She doesn't know what my number is at all. She doesn't have my number at all. She just, yeah. So, I just decided to do this as, like, a little revenge thing because she rejected me. I don't know if it's really revenge, because I understand completely why she rejected me. I was weird as fuck in middle school, I understand. But I just wanted to fucking fuck around with her. And just to let you guys know, this was about, like, 3 o'clock in the morning. So, obviously, she's tired and doesn't want to deal with bullshit. And, I mean, when you get a text message at 3 o'clock in the morning from someone that you don't know, it makes you question and you want to reply, and sometimes you don't reply because you're just like, what the fuck is this number, what the hell. I'm just gonna read you guys the text messages. This shit was fucking hilarious, bro. I don't know if you guys know this song, but it's called One Night by Lil Yachty. I just decided to use this song just to text her because it kind of relates to what had happened. I don't know. No, it doesn't at all. The lyrics are funny as shit and her replies are hilarious, so I'm gonna start really reading the lyrics to you guys right now.
I know you want this for life.
Who even is this?
Taking pictures with all my eyes.
What?
But I can't have no wife. I just want you for the night.
What the actual fuck are you talking about, nigga?
I know you want this for life. Fuck you so good, you be calling out to cry.
Shut the fuck up, dude.
Bottles of the tech, got it laid on ice.
Yo, it's literally 3:30 in the morning. It's dead ass too late for this. Please hit me up tomorrow.
We spent 4 seasons at the 4 Seasons twice.
Are you high? You're obviously talking about another chick.
You be calling all your homegirls like I'm his wife.
Get the fuck out. I am not claiming you.
Tripping, reevaluate your life.
Nigga, you better reevaluate your life and stop hitting me up.
I can't love no bitch, every single hoe is trying.
Who the fuck are you calling a bitch, Harambe looking ass?
I sip dirty Sprite just to get me through the night.
What the actual fuck are you even talking about? Boy, I have no time for this, bye.
But I need you there.
Don't hit me up, please.
Promise that I need you there.
Oh my god, for what? Go away!
Ain't no other bitch gon' fuck me like you do, I swear.
Who is this? Joel?
Put that on my gang, I swear.
Okay.
I just can't put you on front and like you wanna know.
Do you want to try to make sense?
But baby, you is not no hoe.
I know I'm not, but you're a prick.
And I put it on my gang, I'm not no average Joe.
I'm seriously about to block you.
It's Yachty from the block, you know.
Okay, blocked. Middle finger emoji.
Those are all my hopes for her. But yeah, guys, I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Technically, I won't be seeing you. You'll be seeing me because I can't see you through the screen. Unless if I could see you through the screen, that'd be some next online predator shit. But yeah, guys, peace, guys, Swona. Have a nice day. Love you guys. Let's go. If I got a dollar for how many times I said peace, guys, Swona. Have a nice day. I have so many dollars right now. Can you guys count that, please? If you count that, I'll give you $1 through PayPal. $1 can get you some shit from the fucking Dollar Tree. So don't be ungrateful because a lot of people could want to use that $1.